So I had my first graduate this last June, and I did these graduation announcements, and we ran out of some that I needed to send out, so I'm going to make a few more, and I thought I'd do a little tutorial on how to do these fun little graduation. They're more like a party that you could use for a party if you wanted to. So I've already stuck one of the little flags on. Actually, I should show how this is how it's going to look when all the flags are stuck on. So I have these little squares that I get from the dollar store. They're a buck for, I think, like 300. And I stick them on the back of each one of these little pendants that I created with my daughter's name on it. And you stick them on like that. They give it a little three-dimensional look. So the next step is I want to make it really festive and fun. And so I just bought this confetti. I don't even remember how much it was. Just at the party store, it's probably like $2 or $3, maybe $4, I don't know. And I'm gonna add it as an embellishment at the top of the announcement. So you get your tacky glue, and you hope that it's not dried up. And I just put a little bead of glue on the top and the bottom. And then I just take the confetti and kind of press it down. Try to include as many colors as you can get in there. If you want to customize what colors, you can cut up your own tissue and do your own color of tissue. But I just like the mix, it was kind of fun. And I want to get a green in there to kind of add some more color. And then you let that dry. So you don't get your machine all gummed up. I'm gonna take my baker's twine, and you kind of make sure it's centered. Got some glue on my fingers there. Make sure it's centered. And then you wanna sew the zigzag along the top of the little pendants. So I'm gonna kind of pull it out. It'll fall out, and then I'll kind of place it back in there when I sew. So I've got my stitch at a small zigzag, small setting right there, and it's just a little zigzag stitch. So okay, make sure you don't have your baker's twine stuck behind. You start right up there. I start the turning with my hand just so it doesn't start off too fast. Whoops, I got my card stick in there. And your first one takes a little bit of time. I probably did about 70 of these for Chloe. And you get it down faster. It's been a few days since I've actually done the first batch, so I'm kind of out of the sink, but you get it down to where you get fast. You kind of know what to watch for. Okay. We're gonna pretend like that glue is dry and it's not gonna gum up my machine. But we're gonna stitch over that by adding the background. And this just kind of keeps the confetti from falling off. I mean, the glue should stabilize it for the most part, but it kind of keeps it from falling off. And I'm actually just gonna start it right where the confetti starts. Flip those threads front and back. And I'm going to do the bottom. Again, I clip my threads. And there you have the very festive graduation announcement, proving that it's been a party. We inserted this little poem. It's one of our favorite poems by Marianne Williamson that talks about everyone being able to shine. We're all meant to shine. And anyway, so I just painted that up. She loves that quote. We've used it in our family for a long time. So I thought I'd give it as a little gift to the recipients of our announcements. I clip beachside, and you have the little set. And then we include it with her Instagram photo, and we found these great little shiny envelopes that we put it in. Thing when you send off a graduation announcement, sometimes they receive gifts in the mail, and so I wanted to have something personal that Chloe could send out as well, and so we did these little thank yous. I got my thank you stamp at Paper Source, and they have a wide variety of stamps, but I hand calligraphy, and I thought that looked a lot like my own hand calligraphy, so I thought I'd buy that stamp and put thank you, and then we'll have Chloe's pendant down below again. So once again, we're gonna take her name. And we'll do each one of the flags again. So they have these little adhesive backs. Let me just stick it on. And the same thing. Take the little baker's twine, stick it in, and give it a little stitch. It just gives a little personal touch. You want to kind of match up your needle with the zigzag. There we go. With the stitches that have already been made if you run out of thread or something. Own personalized little thank you cards, and these are just 8.5 by 11 paper cut in half, and they have envelopes that are size A2 that you purchase to go with those. You can buy them at any office or paper store.